when the white eagle of the north is flying overhead, and the browns, reds, and golds of autumn lie in the gutter, dead. Remember then the summer birds with wings of fire flame, come to witness spring's new hope, born of leaves decaying. As new life will come from death, love will come with pleasure. Love of life and giving without measure gives in return a wondrous yearning for promise, almost seen. Live hand in hand and together we'll stand on the threshold of a dream.
Share this with you. This will be the only time that I'm ever going to show you why. I will most likely never be in front of the camera. I still have my morning frog voice, so I should probably do this later, but I'll do this as a trial run just to see how it goes. Okay, so because I was always the person that held the camera and took the pictures, women are sex objects, and there's no way to get around it. They always have been, and especially when they're young, and especially if they're pretty. And if you're the one in front of the camera, you are focused on as the object. And when I was young, I went through this a lot, under a lot of different circumstances. And sometimes I used it to my advantage, and sometimes I was taken advantage of. But my dad took the three of us kids to the bank one day, and he wanted to show us the contents of his safety deposit box. So, let me turn this down. I love the Moody Blues. So while we were sitting in this room that was sort of, like a boardroom, you know, it had a table, and, the three of us kids were sitting there waiting, you know, for the safety deposit box to be brought in. So I had my camera everywhere. It was part of who I was. It was attached to my hand. I had a special grip, you know, that my hand slid into like it was a glove. And I just carried my camera everywhere, and you never knew when you'd have an opportunity to take a picture. So you had to be ready all the time. So while we're sitting there waiting, I shoot off a picture of my sister. And this is her when she was probably 18. Either 18 or 19, I'm not sure. She'd gone to New York City with a friend of hers and gotten this haircut. And it was supposed to be a Dorothy Hamill haircut. But unfortunately, she didn't have the kind of hair that would curl under like Dorothy Hamill. She had what I call broomstick hair. It was so straight that when I tried to give her a perm one time, the perm actually relaxed right in front of my very eyes, and it refused to take a curl. But isn't she cute? I've hand-painted that picture, And it has been my favorite picture of my sister ever since I took it. So after I took that picture, I slid the camera across the table and I said, take a picture of me. Because I never get my picture taken, I'm always the one taking the picture. So this is slightly out of focus, but this is the picture that Jan took of me. And I was probably 24, maybe 25. And I made that vest that I had on. It was dark brown velvet, and it was so comfortable. And so I decided to strike a pose. This is me voguing. And so I never did color this one. I did sepia tone it, so it's, you know, brown. But so for the longest time, I didn't frame it. And then finally, when I was living with my dad, I got a bunch of pictures framed because I was going through a lot of things, and I came across this picture in a box of a lot of photographs, you know, I'd taken. And so that's one of the ones I got framed. And then I want to share this one. This is my college picture. And from when I was in high school, I had these really heavy bangs, and they were just too much. So I only went to college for 2 years, but I did get an associate degree in chemistry, which landed me a great job at Kodak as a chemical lab technician. So that's why I have these sort of like sideburn hair pieces on the sides, because that is part of the bangs that I was growing out. And sometime after this picture, I started going into my nature girl phase, where I stopped coloring my hair and I looked really like two-tone for a couple of years. And then finally, when I had my hair long enough that I could cut off the old color, I cut it off, and then, you know, the other picture back behind there is actually my real color, but it's in black and white. So, as you can see, I was very pretty when I was young. And even though I've aged well, people don't think I'm the age that I am. They always consider that I'm maybe 10 or 15 years younger. But, you know, after growing up like that, and even though, you know, I've retained some of my I wouldn't say good looks, but, you know, pleasant looks, I am not ready to be an object in front of a camera talking and having people look at me and basically not pay attention to what I'm saying, but pay attention to what I look like. Because that's what happens with women. And sorry about the frog voice. I think it's from chemtrails. And there have been some chemtrails out there this morning. And I have, you know, maybe some sinus issues from that. And in the morning, it's always worse. So I'm going to stop this now and check the sound and see if it's something that I want to publish.